I need to make a minimum of this, so I need to find a job where I can do that. If I can make a little bit more, it'd be nice, because then I can take my family to the water park, or I can take them to a movie, or I can take them to on a trip, or whatever that looks like. But I think when we start to look for a job, a place to work, you know, ultimately we kind of look at ground zero. What job is in your mind that you think, well, how can I make more money than that? What position in life, what company, you have to have some idea that where it is that you would like to make more money than the people doing that. What is it for you? You know, I can tell you that when I was a child, I wanted to be an airplane pilot. I'm glad I'm not. Now, when I'm fat, the plane would probably crash. But secondly, I made a whole lot more money than any airplane pilot I know. You know, so a lot of times we'll limit ourselves based on the little bit of knowledge or a little bit of information we have about things, rather than finding out the full picture, finding out what is really attainable and what's possible. So we're gonna watch a short video. You guys can kind of see, I don't think it takes a math magician to figure out that we're in sales. It's a sales and marketing company. We are a contract sales company. We have contracts with Windstream, CenturyLink, AT&T, Verizon, Time Warner, and Comcast. You guys ever heard of any of those companies? Yeah, okay. So we have contracts with all those major telecom companies, and we have offices all around the country. We have about 270 sales agents nationwide that are selling these products for these companies every day. In this campaign, the Windstream campaign, I think you can see that based on the sales, the average sale is about $100, $105 a sale. Sometimes you can make more than that, but that's about what you earn on the average sale, about $100, $105 a sale. As you can see, the lowest for the week was 6, and Daryl, you worked 4 days. So we expect you to do a minimum of 10 a week at $105. So we really expect you to minimally be earning $1,050 a week. Marquise.
Yeah.
Can you live on $1,050 a week?
Yeah.
Yeah? Yeah. Okay. All right. How about you, sir? What's your name?
Ron.
Ron. Can you live on $1,000?
For a little while.
Right? Okay. You need more than that?
Yeah.
Praise God, you can get it here. Depends on how much you're willing to do for it, what you're willing to do to get there. So, as you can see, Bobby made $3,000 last week. It really depends on how hungry you are. And I think, with my limited experience in life, I think everything in life depends on how hungry you are. How bad do you really want to achieve? And I don't know what you need to make, Ron, but how bad do you really need that? How bad do you really want to see that happen? Because ultimately, if you just go through life hoping that it happens, the chances get much more slim. But if you go out with a dream and a goal and you're hungry to reach it, then it's a whole lot more obtainable. Do you guys agree with that?
Yes, sir.
Now, before I start the video, out that door, straight through the hallway past the elevators to the bathroom. If you guys feel uncomfortable, the whole team's here except you guys are new. So if you feel uncomfortable and you feel like, hey, this ain't for me, I'm good with that, you won't hurt my feelings, you can catch the elevators up to the first floor and see yourself out. But otherwise, we're just gonna go through this, and hopefully you've heard enough about the company that you kind of know who we are and where we're going. So, play this video.
This is high school, so you don't really know how to grind. Like you talk. Some of y'all been worshiping since you was in high school, so you don't really know how to grind. Like you talk, grind. Like I love it. Like I go into the weight room, Y'all playing big, like y'all all in it. Like you Pac, but you don't have the spirit of Pac. You like love Pac. You like listening to Pac. You like listening to Biggie. You like to talk about the grind, but you don't really know what the grind is like. I know what the grind is like. I was homeless. I ain't out of trash can. Now, go on the internet right now. I'm one of the number one speakers in the world. I started from the bottom. Like, you like listening to it and see. Starting from the bottom. Now, what's your bottom? What is your bottom when you've been worshipped since middle school? You've been tall your whole life, big your whole life. They worship you so much now that you think it's about you. You don't even know what the grind look like.
Yeah, right? So, and you know, it's funny because I played high school ball, had a scholarship to a little small two-year college, Georgia Southern. I was a tight end in high school, a little small school. I was the only person in the whole school to get offered a scholarship, and I didn't take it. I mean, I can stand here and tell you reasons why I didn't take it. I was dating my Spanish teacher. I was the best thing on the team. And you know what happened is, I thought I had arrived. I mean, they offered me a two-year scholarship. I'm like, 2 years? Are you kidding me? Someone needs to offer me a four-year scholarship. I need a full ride, yeah. You know? So we miss opportunities in life. Now, I mean, obviously, if I had taken that path in life, I probably wouldn't be here today. I don't know what different paths will take us in life, but I can tell you that we get in places all along our life where we think we have arrived. I mean, you say that you want to put back in the past, but I can tell you that there's been many times in my life where I was like, man, if I had just grinded it out a little more in high school, I probably would have got a four-year degree. If I had took it a little more serious, or whatever position or whatever thing I went through in life, if I had just taken it a little more serious, then I could have done X, Y, or Z. And it's the most tragic thing, like he said, and it goes along with having some success in life and then having to go back to where you came from. I mean, one of the other worst things in life you can do is have had some success and have to look back and say, if I had only applied myself, what if? What if I had only given everything I had? What if I had just not stopped? What if? And here's the biggest thing, guys, that I think that we battle with in our business and in our life and everything that we do is, what if I had not listened to all the negative people around me getting in my head still in my dreams? What if I had just continued to believe my dreams, just continued to believe I could accomplish the things I wanted to accomplish? What if I had just ignored them? Because here's the thing that I found out. If you want to make $100,000 a year, who do you think you ought to ask?
Somebody
that's done it, right? But now, your mom and your daddy might not have made $100,000 a year. Mine didn't. I don't think they ever knew what, they may not have made $100,000 in their lifetime. We were so poor. My father-in-law, I love him to death. I mean, my father-in-law is the dearest man I've ever met. If I need brakes on my car, I mean, he's 80, 70, 76 years old. If I need brakes on my car, he can get it done. If I have an air conditioned hose that's broke, he can get it done. If I need the oil change, he can get it done. If I need to build a box, which I can't even build a box if you give me four pieces of wood that's the right size. If I need to build a box, he can get it done. But what he can't do, and he's tried to do, and I've been married to his daughter for 26 years, is he's tried to tell me how to manage my finances. He's tried to tell me how to live my life and in my company and in my business. I can tell you that when I first started contract sales, I traveled a lot. I'm traveling now. I'm from Tampa, Florida. Whenever I got the call from Windstream about this contract, I talked to the guy who was in charge, and I said, look, man, you know, I need to know what kind of platform we're getting into here, because it's Wednesday afternoon, 2 o'clock. I'm on the golf course. I ain't thinking about Nebraska right now, you know. And that was back in February. I don't know if you guys know, but when I got here in May, it was still 52 degrees. That was cold to me. Like, that's a winter day for us in Florida. So for me to take a look at that, I needed to kind of know what we were getting into. And then to get on the road and travel again from Florida to come to Nebraska, it was a big decision to do that. But my father-in-law, when I first started in the contract sales, he's like, well, you know, I wouldn't, and it's tough. Listen to me, it's hard. And I'm going to tell you something. I don't care how old your family is. I don't care how old your kids are. I don't care how long you've been married. I don't care if they're an infant. I don't care if they're 5. I don't care if they're 12. I don't care if they're 17. I promise you this. If you walk out that door and you leave your kids behind to go travel, to go to work somewhere, and you don't see them for weeks or months, it is the hardest thing for them at that time in their life. It doesn't matter what time in their life it is. For them, it's the hardest time. I can tell you that my daughter, still today, she'll be 21 August the 18th. She called me last night just to talk. She misses me. I'm her buddy. I'm her friend. I'm also her father first. So just for young folks in the room, when you get kids, be a father first. It's okay to be a friend, but be a father first. My son, 26 years old, calls me just to chat. Who's your favorite, Dad? That's what they called me for last night. I'm your favorite, aren't I, Dad? But it's hard. It's hard sometimes to sacrifice what has to be sacrificed for greatness and for what you want. You have to be willing to do today what most people aren't willing to do so you can do later what most people can't do. And if you don't, you'll always look back and say, what if I had done this or what if I had done that? So here's the thing. There's a couple things that have to be present for you to make that kind of commitment. Number one, you have to have a heart. And I tell my team, you want success, you want massive success, you have to have a heart transplant. I'm not a physician, I can't do it for you. But you can do a heart transplant on yourself. You have to come to a point in your life where you say, it doesn't matter what it takes, it doesn't matter what I have to do, as long as it's legal, moral, and ethical, I'm gonna do what it takes to do it. And then secondly, you have to have the right vehicle. Because here's the thing, how many of you guys ever worked in a fast food restaurant? How many of you ever did, I know you did construction. I can tell you that when I was right out of high school, I worked at a brick factory or a concrete block factory. And my job was, it was a really important job, when the bricks came out of the oven and they cured, my job was to take them off the thing and stack them. Took a lot of brains to do that. But it didn't matter how hard I worked. It didn't matter if I was the best person there. It didn't matter if I had my block stacked and another kid's over here falling behind. He made the same money I made. And I could never, ever reach that level of earning potential that I wanted to reach. So you have to be in the right vehicle. If you worked in a fast food restaurant, you could be the best fry cook. You could flip the best burger. You could be in a pizza parlor. You could throw the best pizza dough and throw it behind your back and all that stuff that they do. But I promise you this, that won't get you massive success because it has a ceiling, it has a limit to what you can earn. So you have to find a vehicle, you have to find something where you are paid or you are rewarded for exactly how much work you do. And if you do more than you get paid for, you'll eventually get paid for more than you do. So when you get into something, whether it's here, Ron, or Marquise, or whether it's somewhere else, and you're probably my age or a couple days older, I don't know, but you're clearly a mature individual. Whether it's here or somewhere else, if you go into it with the mindset that you're just going to do what it takes to get by, that's where you're going to be your entire life. I don't know everything. In fact, I don't know much about anything. If you ask me, my daughter just blew out her tire in a car and I had to get her a new rim. She drove it. I don't know how long she drove it, but it punctured a hole in the chrome rim. So I had to get her a rim, get her a tire. It was crazy. I had to do all over the phone. But the guy asked me, he says, well, what size tire is that? I said, I don't know. I have no clue. Well, can you look? I said, look where? I don't know anything about that. I'm like, it's a Nissan. It's a Nissan Maxima. It's a 2014. I mean, don't you know what's on there? You know, I don't know how to do that. I don't know how to change the oil in your car. I barely know how to put gas in my car. Seriously. Like, I run out of gas a couple times because it's not important to me. But I do know this. I know that if you will work as hard as you can possibly work, doing the right thing in the right vehicle, you can have massive success. That I know. And the only reason I know that, and maybe what I consider massive success